As mentioned in our introduction, we need to control and monitor every step of the process. Telling the worker what to do in the operator guidance system isn't good enough. We need to physically control if the tool's enabled or disabled, depending on where the tool is in relation to the job that we require the worker to do. Traditionally, position monitoring and control has been realised with mechanical frames, like in the picture. They can be very restrictive, costly, and are difficult to solve the insulation requirements in battery manufacturing. We have partnered with a company called Soft2Tech that have a brand name called Nexonar, and it is a unique tracking technology. Nexonar uses infrared-based technology. No special lighting's required. No ultrasonic problems with compressed air. And no pictures to worry about with GDPR issues. A Nexonar system is made up of simple building blocks. We have a camera. We have active tags on the tool and also on the workpiece. We have a teach pendant to make it easy to teach positions. And then we have a piece of software that reads the detail from the camera and works out which tag is in which position. You can see in the picture in the bottom that we've got virtual positions, and here we've got spheres that we've taught the Nexonar system. So as the tool goes into the sphere, it gives it a positive signal and it can enable its program because it's in the correct place. The picture to the left shows what we call differential position. What this means is the camera can move, the tool can move, the job can move, but the position is calculated differentially between the three parts. That means that we have the system accuracy, which is typically a few millimetres, regardless of the exact location of any of the components. The important point is the difference in position between the components. So now let's see how easy it is to create a position with a name. This is Assembly Scout, and what this does is teaches positions. So I've created a panel, and I'm now going to create some positions in that panel. Dynamic refers to a reference tag. This area picks which device we're using to teach the positions. Device 6 is my teach pad. And now I'm going to create a position, and I'm going to call it BM1-B1. And this will be our first bolt, as in our operator guidance demo. I've got three physical shapes that I can choose. And here I'm choosing a sphere with a 20 millimeter radius. I push the teach pendant into the place that I want to teach, and then teach point. And you can see the teach pad is now 0 millimeters away. As I move the teach pad away, you can see I'm getting dynamic feedback on how far it's away from the point that I've taught. We've got 4 points in our demo program, so I'm going to create 3 more points and give them different names, BM1-B2. Three and four. So B1's already been taught. So now we'll put the teach probe onto the second position and press the teach position. Third, teach position. And finally, number 4. I apply changes, and we're now ready to go. Now that we have taught the Nexonar system 4 positions for our battery, let's see how easy it is to integrate these into our operator guidance system. Here we are back in OGS Configurator, and we open our job. We have the 4 steps. And to make these position sensitive, all we need to do is check the PS number from 0 to 1. That means these steps are position sensitive. And next, here in the position variable, we type the symbol name that we created in Nexonar. So BM1-B1-B2-B3-B4. These four bolting operations are now linked to the physical positions. The tool will not enable until the tool is in the correct place. Join us for our final video in the series, where we look at integration and a demonstration of the total solution.